next week, I will be forced to move myself down significantly. Everybody hurts sometimes. All right, welcome back to week four of Bakes Takes. I'll just jump right into it this week. No need to sit here and make small talk or chit chat. I'm going to start here at the number 10 spot and work my way up to one. Coming in at number 10 this week, hate to say it, we do have Random Football Club myself. As the only 0-3 team, I think I have more than earned and deserved this number 10 spot. And until I pick up my first win, I will go ahead and just keep myself there. I am nothing if not objective about this. So again, while I didn't hate my lineup there week one, week two, I was trying to hold out hope. At some point you have to win a football game. So right there, I'm going to keep myself the 10th spot until I do get that first win. Number nine, we have Luke with the fewest total points in the league. Things just still aren't looking bright for Luke. He does have the one win, but other than that, things are just not looking good. Just not a lot of points have been put up by him thus far. And therefore, he has that number nine spot. Number eight, we have Kevin. He came in at number 10 last week. Limped over 100 points this week for his first win. Nothing's going to look easy this year for him. He'll eke out a few wins, but he's going to make it look difficult all year. And this, I don't see this being Kevin's year. Number seven, we have Jared. I kind of was keeping there, kind of upper half, middle of the pack in the first 2 weeks, but he must have seen things differently because he's kind of started a fire sale a little bit. I mean, parting with Lenny Fournette, parting now with Dalvin Cook. When he had both those running backs, I thought his lineup looked fine, but without those two players, and looks like he's just kind of become a seller, not a buyer this year. So I don't see Jared really making much noise, mostly due to his own actions. Number six, we have Kyle. I don't know, picked up another loss, 1-2. The lineup is just kind of destined for mediocrity this year. Nothing appalling, but just nothing there that is going to make him any bit of a contender this year. Number five, we have Andrew. James Robinson has really come on strong for him. He seems to be the running back to own down there in Jacksonville. Really, it's just that Tyreek Hill trade. I guess I don't know if it was just not having full faith in his team, but he trades Tyreek Hill for a couple picks and then Robbie Anderson, and then promptly drops Robbie Anderson. So, I mean, as far as this year's concerned, essentially just parted with Tyreek Hill, which kind of just limits his ceiling this year. So while he'll be competitive this year, I think that loss of Tyreek is going to kind of hinder him from really jumping up those rankings and really competing for a championship this year. Number four, we have Brendan. This has been a steep ascension here since my first power rankings, but Lamar is just on one right now. He's kind of picked up Dalvin Cook and Tyreek Hill to go along with Lamar. To kind of just add a lot of pop to other positions. And if Lamar keeps playing this way, Brendan's going to be a tough out. And, even if Lamar is a down week or two, he does now have pieces that can kind of, keep him in games. So as of now, he just took down the number one team on my power rankings land. So had to bump him up significantly. He is now in the number four spot. I'll kind of keep this brief because there's been no adjustments here to the top three. Number three, we still have Eric. We look like we might still be searching for a wide receiver too, but other than that, the lineup just looks strong. He's gonna be a tough one each and every week. Number two, we have Ty. So Ty, I'm holding him there at the number two spot. I mean, we just have not gotten much from our running back position this year. If Kamara keeps playing the way he has, and Javonte Williams doesn't quite pick it up either, Ty could see a fall here shortly, but I still like his lineup enough. Mahomes has probably the best wide receiver core of anyone in the league, and then I still think Kamara will be fine at the end of the day. So I'm going to keep him there at the two spot. And then Lance, I'm gonna keep him at the number one spot despite his first loss of the year. I mean, just with Jalen Hurts, Justin Jefferson has a lot of potential points up and down that lineup. I feel like he maybe missed an opportunity with his team name without going with something Taylor Swift related, but those two running backs are gonna be really, really strong for him all year. And I'm gonna keep Lance there at the number one spot. This week's
Bricked Up
Manager of the Week is Brendan Mahoney. I mean, it just has to be. Lamar is putting on an absolute show right now. The trades with Dalvin Cook and Tyreek Hill have really bolstered that lineup, and he's kind of just conjured up a team now that I don't know if you really want to face week in and week out. He just took down my perennial number one ranked team, Lance. So, I mean, if Brendan's not bricked up right now, then I don't know what to tell you. So that's why the Week 3 Bricked Up Manager of the Week is Brendan Mahoney. All right, I think that's all I got for you guys today. Hopefully next time I see you, I have added my first win to that win column. But, you know, we're just going to have to wait and see. So appreciate you guys for tuning in. Play well.